here at a city housing project, the Jacob Riis Houses on the Lower East Side. Joining us this morning to talk about it is Jeremy Del Rio, the founder as well as president of Generation XL. Good morning.
Good morning.
All right, let's start from the top. Tell us a little bit about Generation XL. What kind of program is it?
Generation XL began in March of 1996 when a group of 15 teens from the Lower East Side decided they had had enough with drugs, gangs, and poverty. They made a determination to learn how to excel and to bring their community along with them. They volunteered for 2 years running tutoring programs, computer classes, athletics, dance and drama activities, and benefited 350 kids in the year that they were open.
Okay, now you were operating right behind us out of this project here on the Lower East Side as subtenants.
That's correct. We were subtenants of a group called the Puerto Rican Council.
Okay, and then you were recently evicted by the Housing Authority. Tell us how that came about.
Housing notified us that they would be evicting the group that we were subtenants of. But for 10 months, they promised that once the other group was evicted, they would make us the primary leaseholders of the space. Then, without warning, in September of 1997, they told us we could not continue our operations past Labor Day. They never provided any explanation why. No matter what kind of inquiries we made, whether it was to the chairman's office, the community operations office, even the mayor's office, nobody has provided us with any explanation for this eviction.
Well, we did speak to the Housing Authority. They told us that you were squatters, that you had no right to be there in the first place. And they also said, and this is a quote from the Housing Authority, we could not get a scrap of information from them, meaning you.
That's complete nonsense. When we opened, even though we were subtenants of this other group, we introduced ourselves to the Housing Authority, to the Tenants Association. We provided them with every kind of information they ever asked us for. We began paying for insurance in November of 1996 upon their request. We had numerous meetings with the Community Operations Office, the Chairman's Office. We have volunteered every piece of information we had, including budgetary information, the names of all the participants. Whenever they asked us, we provided them with everything and more.
Okay, and one final question. You are not shut down now. You're operating nearby out of a church in the meantime?
Well, we haven't been able to do all of our activities because all of our equipment is still locked inside the center. But we have done a lot of the community organizing and activism out of a church space. We've done phone calls, flyers, petition drives, faxes, all kinds of things. And that, too, has been led entirely by teens who are working for free.
Okay, Jeremy Del Rio of Generation XL, thanks so much for coming out and speaking to us this morning. Pat, we are going to be following this story, and a little bit later on, we are going to be speaking to the Housing Authority to hear exactly why this group was evicted and ultimately what will happen, hopefully. We are on the Lower East Side. Annika Pergament, New York One. Back to you.
Looking forward to hearing the other side, Annika. Thank you.
New York One is now available on the World Wide Web.